And yet still, the White House put out a raft of statements defending Rob Porter.
Oh, saying he had the highest character and integrity.
And not even addressing the allegations at all.
I think that somebody did ask Rashaan, we'll ask my team in the control room to get this bite. I think somebody said, what do you mean by he didn't fully know? And I think Rashaan said, he referred to the visual evidence, meaning he hadn't seen the photograph of, I believe, the first ex-wife with a black eye. Amanda Carpenter, you are also a former communications director. Can you think of a way where the White House could have handled this worse?
The bottom line is this, is that they protected an abuser. And guess what is a job qualification to work in this White House? It's to protect someone who talked favorably about sexual assault on the Access Hollywood tapes. That is a job qualification in this White House. There is a pattern of behavior. They kept Corey Lewandowski on staff as a campaign manager after he bruised a reporter.
Michelle Fields, yeah.
Yes. This is the same president who laughs along with Howard Stern when he says disgusting things about his daughter. I don't know how the people in the White House let this man date Hope Hicks, get alone in a car with him.
Rob Porter, you're referring to. Yeah.
Yes, knowing this was in his file. They protect abusers. There's no way of getting around it. And I guess people will say, well, it doesn't matter. You can still be a good president. You can still do your job. No, if you are willing to defend someone who hurts somebody in this fashion, you have no boundaries, you have no restraint, you have no respect for the law. And if you tolerate people who do this to people they say they love, what will they do to the people they don't know? And that's why I think this matters to a normal person. These people don't have restraint, and it is disgusting to watch. My heart is pounding. It's infuriating to see people go to the White House and defend this as a conservative, as a woman, as an American, as anyone.
So one of the things an interesting point that you just raised is Rob Porter is not the first person in this White House to be accused of domestic abuse. Steve Bannon had been accused of domestic abuse by his first wife. Andy Puzder, who was the Secretary of Commerce or Labor, Secretary of Labor nominee, who withdrew his nomination, I think mainly because of Nannygate issues. His ex-wife actually put on a disguise and went on Oprah and talked about the abuse, although now she denies that there was any abuse. I mean, this is something of a pattern.
Yes, no doubt. I mean, I think of